We know that students struggle to take notes while learning new and complex topics. Using sketchnoting strategies helps all students succeed. Showing your thinking visually to students in order to introduce complex topics is proven to capture student interest and deepen their learning by creatively representing essential information in a fun and new way, conveying and grappling with complex ideas with images and symbols, and making complex ideas easy to understand across any subject and for students at all levels. I'll teach you how to sketchnote to present new concepts and materials to students. We'll start with defining your visual alphabet. These are simple glyphs and symbols you can combine in a variety of ways to create simple drawings that carry a lot of meaning. Don't worry if you think you don't know how to draw. This course is for everyone. You will quickly learn to present new information and to synthesize complex information visually for your students. Follow along with me. I'll be using Adobe Scan, Express, and Fresco. Don't forget to pause this video and log into your Adobe Creative Cloud account. Now I'm going to introduce you to what a visual alphabet is and how to use it. All right, so what I'm going to show you now is a visual alphabet, and you're going to use this to help you build your drawings kind of from the ground up. And a visual alphabet is made up of five or six of these glyphs, if you will. And the first thing that you can draw with the visual alphabet is a rectangle. The next is a circle, and then a triangle, simple dot, some lines, kind of this blob shape. So think of a visual alphabet similar to an actual alphabet where we take letters and we build words, words that are combined to make sentences. You're gonna take these glyphs and you're gonna assemble them together to make larger drawings. So now, how can I combine these in order to make larger images? So we're gonna start with a clean piece of paper and we'll start with a rectangle. I'm gonna draw a few of these. So in this one, I'm gonna incorporate some lines. And I've drawn kind of a simple building. I can even kind of build off of that. And go on to this next one, and maybe I could turn this into maybe a cell phone or a tablet, draw some apps inside of it. The idea is to keep this very simple and very quick, because you want to get these ideas out of your head and you don't want to overthink what it is you're drawing. Let's look at maybe making this into kind of a notebook. Maybe we're talking about journaling. Then we can move on to one of the other shapes. So maybe a triangle. Well, we can turn these into mountains just by adding that kind of blob shape. You can combine rectangles with more triangles. You have arrows. Add in some more pieces. Now we have a bike. Maybe take in a triangle, draw it upside down, add in some more triangles. And you kind of have this diamond or this gem. Then when you get really good with triangles, you can combine them other ways. You can make stars. Now these are really simple. This is kind of how I want you to think about drawing. I don't want you to overcomplicate what it is that you're drawing. I want you to keep it simple. So now I'm taking circles. Let's draw more planets. Maybe we take rectangles, we have a triangle, now we have rockets, and add the blob. But this is kind of how drawing works. If you're able to take larger images, break it up into smaller images, you're able to draw just about anything. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna move on to people. So how do I draw people? So typically what we do is we try to kind of play this game, right? We draw our stick figures, which are totally fine. So another way to draw people is to stick with those basic shapes. Some legs, maybe some arms, and a head. But now what I've done is I've created this body where I can add details that might be important to a character. So maybe this character always wears a t-shirt with maybe a lightning bolt in it. Maybe this person is wearing a robe of some sort. And that's it. That's kind of how you draw people using basic shapes. Another quick way to draw groups of people, instead of trying to draw several stick people, you kind of just do this. And now I have kind of a crowd of people. And if you need to, you can go back and add details to their clothing to maybe set them apart from one another. All right, so now we've talked about a visual alphabet, how you can move from that to simple icons, from the simple icons to people. Then we get into lettering, because as you're taking notes, you're gonna have different types of words that you're gonna use. I would just try to stick with two types of I guess, typefaces when you're drawing. I would stick with your title and your body text. And this should really just be your handwriting. Now, to set these two apart is you can just take your title and you can add extra lines to the words, or to the letters, excuse me. So now you're just making that a little bit thicker. You're not getting too fancy. If you want to add some serifs to it, you can do that too. But now you've created two different typefaces to help you take your notes or help you capture an idea and some kind of hierarchy to it. And the body text should just be your simple handwriting. All right, so what does this look like when it's all put together? Let's talk about how I've used it in the classroom with kids. One of the ways that I've used it with kids is teaching the branches of government. It's always a concept that we have to teach in middle school, and trying to keep kids organized in their thinking and organizing on how this works. Is what I like to do is I actually like to draw the actual buildings that belong to each of the branches of government. And they each really just start with three rectangles. And from there, I build up. So let's talk about the legislative branch first. Essentially what you're doing is you're creating a graphic organizer from the ground up. In the past, what we would do is we would typically give students the graphic organizer and tell them to memorize it rather than trying to have them organize it. So the next one is the executive branch. Well, the executive branch is your president and your vice president, right? Well, those guys live kind of in the White House. So we call that the executive branch. And then finally, we have our Supreme Court. Our Supreme Court is our judicial branch. And that building kind of looks like this. So then we label it. Now at least the students have an idea of where these locations are that we're talking about. But who's inside of these? Who's inside doing the work, right? So we start with our legislative branch. We know that has two houses. We have the House of Representatives and we have our Senate. And then we kind of go from there, we go into our executive branch who has two people. We have our president. So remember that stick figure that we were drawing? And we have our vice president. And if you want, you can always go back and add more detail, but I'm just gonna keep it simple. Now, remember I told you about drawing groups of people? Well, the judicial branch has our Supreme Court. There's nine justices. So instead of drawing nine stick figures, and go back to this little strategy I gave you earlier, and just like that, I have nine people. Then we talk about terms and how long they are to serve in these roles. So I draw like kind of a little checkbox to talk about voting. So the House of Representatives, they serve two-year terms. And our senators have six-year terms. I kind of draw this infinity symbol again. Gets a little different with our president. Our president can serve four-year terms, and so forth. And you kind of keep continuing drawing, but now you've created this simple graphic organizer. And anytime I would talk or teach kids about this, I would redraw each of these and reference the drawing. I kept it very simple because I would draw these over and over and over and over again. And what's nice is to see students, before they take a test or before they answer questions, redraw this simple graphic organizer to kind of represent the branches of government. So that's it. With intentional colors, design elements, and shapes, I used a visual alphabet and sketchnoting to teach students about the three branches of government. You can use any topic or subject area to meet the needs of your students. Now take a moment to reflect. What can you take away from this lightning learning into your own classroom practice right away? If you need inspiration, we have some examples of how sketchnoting and templates are being used in the classroom here on edX. I've provided some awesome examples below this tutorial. In our next video, you will learn how to help students think visually in Scan, Express, and in Fresco.